your running shoes on. We have a very interesting and inspirational show for you today. We are here with our special guest, Felicia McClain, who is a friend of ours who attends our church that my husband and I went to and we grew up in, St. John CME. And Felicia is a runner, but not a regular old runner. She is a super runner with a high goal of running a half marathon, 13.1 miles in all 50 states before the age of 50. Bless her. Yeah. Anyway, welcome, Felicia.
Thank you.
We're so glad you're finally here with us. We've been talking to Felicia for a while about trying to do something. So we're glad you're here. Welcome.
Thank you.
So I know your first question is my first question. What caused you to want to run a marathon, run even across the street, but run a marathon in all 50 states? So describe your journey and how you got to your marathon journey.
Wow. This is interesting. Okay. I didn't really actually start off wanting to run a marathon. Mm-hmm. One day I was out eating dinner with girlfriends, and we were sitting around the table, and I looked at everyone's plate at the time, and I looked at my plate, and I had a little bit more, and I looked at their size and my size, and I got depressed, and I wasn't happy. Mm-hmm. And the very next day, I joined a gym. It was a small, very quaint gym in the area where I live, mm-hmm. and they had a fitness challenge. It's like it was during Lent. Mm-hmm. And I joined that challenge, and I was in the gym day and night for the whole 6 weeks. Wow. And so I ended up winning third place. And during that time, one of my closest girlfriends mentioned about this running group, Black Girls Run. And she said that D.C. had a chapter. Well, I live in Maryland, Southern Maryland, so pretty far. So I joined the D.C. chapter, but never went out to run with them. And then a couple of weeks later, she says, hey, there's a Southern Maryland chapter as well. And so I looked them up on Facebook, I joined the group, and there I was, going out, finding about the different races and where they meet, and just started off just like anyone else. The first start was getting off the couch.
Wow.
And that started my journey. And the rest is history.
Yay! Well, we're going to talk about all this history because there's a whole lot of history in just a very short time.
Okay. Yes, I'm just amazed at all these beautiful medals. Can you just give us the story behind these medals? I mean, I'm looking at all these medals here, and I'm just fascinated. They're so intriguing.
Wow. Well, I must first start off with this Black Girls Run medal because, as I told you, this was the first group that I joined, and I received this medal in Trenton, New Jersey, when I did the Trenton half marathon. But this is very significant and very dear to my heart because this is what started my journey.
Mm-hmm.
This here is the Divas. I ran the Divas half marathon in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was very fun. It was a lot of women. You know, it was fun. We wore crowns and boas and, you know, tutus and costumes and so forth.
And pretty down there.
This one here is just because it's Mercedes-Benz.
That's right.
So this one's in Alabama, and it was fun. It was a great race, but I love the emblem, as we call it, the bling.
Oh, yeah.
I'll save the best for last. This here is the Disney Princess half. I ran this through Disney World. So it's very fun. It's like a little girl, you know, the little girl's dream going to Disney and running through the park with, you know, you've seen all the Disney characters. I was able to stop and take pictures with the characters I had on my costume as well. So it was pretty fun. This Delaware half, I ran this one, not this past weekend, but last weekend. This was a very good race. So for anyone that's close in the area, this race here is by far, you know, the logistically, it was very nice. They gave out a lot of fun items. The course was great, and so I really recommend this. It was just a fun race.
Wow.
Delaware, because it's close to home.
Right.
And this one here is a Kentucky Derby. I ran this one during Easter weekend, and actually I was able to run actually through the Derby. I'd never experienced it, to see the horses, and I was able to stop and take pictures. So just going through all the races and the journey and just meeting people and the visual itself just makes it so much more fun.
Yeah.
Last but not least, this is the Marine Corps Marathon. This is when I did my first 26.2 miles.
Wow.
This is by far, this was a life changer for me because this is something I never thought I would do.
Like,
you know, not to mention the 13.1, but running the Marine Corps Marathon was a memory that I will never forget. So
now these, are you allowed to stop, you know, and when you're doing these things, or do you have to keep going right through to get these medals? I mean, how does that work?
No, you don't have to stop. Most races will tell you, you know, on the website prior to running a race, they have timelines. You know, okay. They'll tell you where it's, like for the Marine Corps Marathon, whether it's 7 hours or 6 hours or so forth. And then you'll know. You can stop as long as you want, you know, get water or walk
okay,
if you're tired or something.
That's what I was wondering. So you can stop and refresh yourself. That would make sense. I mean, 26
yes.
miles, you
yes.
got to have something mm-hmm. to do something to refresh yourself. But you just have it. But as long as you cross that finish line within the time frame they give you,
yes.
then you can get
a absolutely. Can
so, get- so give us some training tips. How do you get in shape for
mm-hmm.
something like this?
Yeah.
Mentally and physically.
Yes.
Okay. So you first have to come up with a training plan.
Right.
So there's no way, I wouldn't recommend anyone who's running a half marathon or full marathon to just go out one day and say, just because I ran track in high school, I can do this.
Uh-huh.
There are training plans online.
Mm-hmm.
So you can just Google it. Half marathon training plans, marathon training plans. There are various ones. You know,
mm-hmm.
you get the Hal Higdon.
Mm-hmm.
You have so many different ones. And then you find the one that best fits you.
What do you do?
Well, I use the Hal Higdon method for my full marathon.
Okay.
And it just tells you how many days a week and how many miles to run
okay.
per weekday, you know,
okay.
like Monday, Wednesday, Tuesday, you know, through the week. And your long run is pretty much on the weekend. So it tells you what to do. And I try to follow it as much as possible.
Well, do you do basic exercises? Are there certain exercises in the gym or stretching things or whatever to really limber up?
Stretching is very, very important,
yeah.
mm-hmm. you know, for
mm-hmm.
running because
mm-hmm.
your legs and your muscles can get very tight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's all highly recommend that you do a lot of stretching and
okay.
cross train as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a bike.
Okay.
And so I got a bike
Good.
Since I've been running, and that kind of loosened up my muscles.
Yeah.
So it definitely helps me.
Mm-hmm.
And then I lift
mm-hmm.
weights, light weights
okay.
as well, because, you know, your body, your muscles get weak. And so,
mm-hmm.
of course, you need, you know, to build your muscles back
mm-hmm.
up because you're steadily pounding on your body and so forth.
Right.
So you need
right.
that strength.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to ask you, too. What advice, and you're kind of giving it now, like what advice or precautions would you know, give to people out there who are thinking about doing what you're doing, maybe not on your level, but thinking about running any kind of marathon or half marathon?
Right. Well, I highly recommend first get clear by your doctor.
Absolutely.
Because you have so many people that will go out there and assume that they can take this on because
mm-hmm.
their friends are doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very important to get clear.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we may have those underlying conditions that we don't know about.
Yes.
And, you
your
know, sitting.
Feet, ankle, and knees.
That is
oh
correct.
My gosh.
That is correct. Mm-hmm. And things happen.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely, you want to educate yourself. You want to find
mm-hmm.
out. You want to join groups and clubs and people that are doing it. You want to find like-minded people that can help you that have been on this journey for a while as well.
Mm-hmm.
So you can ask questions too, you know, because it's not something that you do on your own.
Okay.
And then when you start running, you want to get a training plan, you know,
mm-hmm.
so that you can, you know, have something to go by. You just don't get out there, oh, wake up one morning, what am I going to do today? You know,
mm-hmm.
do I just get up and run? So you know exactly what you want to do to meet your goals.
Okay. So did you do anything like this, run or anything athletic when you were younger,
you know,
as a child?
I was always athletic.
Okay.
And the interesting thing is that I was in the military.
Okay.
And so in the military, we had to run, but,
mm-hmm.
you know, max, you know, every 6 months, we did a PRT, which was 1.5 mile.
Okay.
And so, you know, I mean, I wouldn't say that was tough, but I wasn't training for it.
Right.
So I would just wake up knowing that it was that day. Okay, I got to go out here and run this 1.5 miles.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
But looking back at it now, it's like... now this is more leisurely for myself
mm-hmm.
now. So
right,
wow.
That's nothing. You know, wow. looks like on 1 mile.
Yeah,
walking,
1.5 miles.
When you walk to the car, you know.
I've never done a marathon before. I mean, I will run and jog a little bit. I'll walk and jog and alternate, but I really don't like running. I know you love this. Like I always tell myself, I don't like to run, but I know when I'm done. If when I'm done jogging, I feel so good.
Mm-hmm.
It makes you feel good.
Do you get that runner's high that people
mm-hmm.
talk about?
I do. I have it. And, you know, since I've been on this journey, you know, like even yesterday, day before yesterday, I traveled to New York to run a half marathon. And on my travel on the train, I was literally looking for another race to run.
Wow.
So, I mean, who does that? And looking at my calendar, you know, to see whether or not I can fit it in.
Uh-huh.
Because I am on this journey to run the 50 states.
NFL. Yeah. That's awesome. That is awesome. What a great way to see the country. Mm-hmm. One thing I want to ask you, what changes in your overall health, if any, have you seen as a result of having run all these races? How has it impacted your health?
You know, I've never really had any major health issues. Believe it or not, I do have little knee problems. But I do try to watch that a little bit, make sure I do. But I just see myself as being more healthy. I'm much more active now. Mm-hmm. It's a lifestyle change. Yes. I've changed my diet. Okay. Don't get me wrong, I still eat those same things occasionally, but I eat it in moderation.
Yes. Okay.
And so I've kind of curved it a little bit.
Anything that you completely cut out that you know that you just don't do anymore? Or you pretty much do...
I still do it, but I eat more of. I will say now I eat more vegetables.
Okay.
And then I know when it's race time, I find I know what I can eat prior to the race. Mm-hmm. So I'll make sure that my diet through the week sometimes is kind of a little bit cleaner. Because I don't want to eat. Now, fried foods, I try to stay away from fried foods,
yeah.
Period.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
I do. That is something that I never did a whole lot, but I'm more conscious now to stay away from the fried foods.
Okay. So how do these groups really inspire you, and kind of get you prepped and that kind of thing? And I definitely want you to share about your girlfriends that you were eating dinner with before.
Well, they've inspired me because... I mean, it's just amazing. You guys look at me and see the few medals that I have, but I have some friends that are absolutely amazing who have run the 50 states, who've run all the continents, who've run full marathons, and, wow. Different people in the running groups and the running clubs that I'm in that's so inspiring. And, now they're doing triathlons and so much more. So I look at my journey as small, for me, looking at what they're doing, but I try to focus on my journey and not really, focus on what they're doing because,
Keep your eye on the target. Exactly.
But they truly inspire me. And, we communicate a lot through our Facebook groups and our running clubs. Mm-hmm. And so we help each other out. So if we have questions, there's always someone there to... answer our questions and tell us, hey, what you need to be doing. If I have my ankle's hurting, I can just go on there and just like a blog and say, hey, I'm having these pains. And not that they're doctors, but people who have similar issues, they can kind of talk on it.
Okay. Well, when we come back, we have a whole lot more questions.
All right.
I hope you keep your running shoes on. I hope you didn't take them off. But we'll be right back. More with Felicia and the Running the Marathon.
Yes.
All right, I know this isn't any fun to talk about, but we should. Okay, so who's going to do what?
I'll pack the dead batteries.
Great.
I'll only put what I don't need into a duffel bag.
Perfect, that's totally unhelpful.
No problem.
Meanwhile, I will try to comfort everyone by speaking in a calm voice.
And I'll try to get the generator going without any gas.
Oh, let's not forget the cell phones, which probably won't work.
Right.
And who is going to handle supplies?
I can forget to do a list for us.
Thanks, pal.
Well, I think we couldn't be any less prepared. I'm proud of you guys.
Talk to your kids about who to call, where to meet, what to pack. Visit ready.gov/kids for tips and information.
I don't know what's happening. Start a new check. What did I do? Okay. Wow. That is so weird.
Hey! Hi!
Hi! Oh my gosh.
Hi!
God, I don't even know what to say right now. I'm so nervous.
Gia, you're so big.
Come closer to the camera. Wait, now you're in my face.
Bye.
That was so good.
Well, welcome back to Life Matters. We are here with a very intriguing Felicia McLean. And if you didn't see the first half of the show, Felicia's goal is to run 50 half marathons in 50 states. And I tell you what, I'm tired from what she's already done from the first half of the show. So, Felicia, you've run a certain number of marathons or half marathons already. What's been your favorite location and why?
So my favorite location, I would have to say, I have two. So location-wise was Delaware and Kentucky Derby. And the reason why is because I'd never been to either. Even though I'm so close to Delaware, it's very close, but I've never been to either race. But Delaware, because of the logistics, the race, it was a flat course, and you know, runners can appreciate a flat course instead of hills.
Yeah.
They give you a lot of different little nice items. You get a, I got a ball cap, I got a glass. We call it swag.
Okay.
So they give out a lot of swag, got a little cute towel, you know, a backpack. So they give out really nice stuff. So you think about it, it's like, okay, so it was my money's worth. Even though I ran it, nice course.
And relatively close to home.
And relatively close to home. So like, it didn't cost that much.
Right.
So, and then also the Kentucky Derby. Kentucky Derby was my first time in Kentucky. And it was just absolutely beautiful. I mean, the crowd, the support, it was between 20 and 30,000 people there. The course was flat. I've seen the Kentucky Derby itself on television, but I actually got to run through the grounds. And so to see the horses, you know, people practicing on the horses, I stopped to take pictures. So I didn't completely run this one straight through. I stopped. So I enjoyed it because I enjoyed the scenery as well and great people too.
Wow. Wait, did you call this your passion, your purpose? Now that you've done as much as you've done, I mean, is, would you say so?
I do. I really think so. I mean, I think, you know, my daughter went off to college. And so it was me as a single woman with no family living in this area. And so it's like, you know, since I got on this journey for fitness, you know, what am I going to do with my time? Mm-hmm. You know, so much free time. And so when I decided to do the 50 states, 50 half marathons, it became a passion. Mm-hmm. And so much of what I do in my planning, even sitting here today interviewing with you guys, I had to determine, was this a good fit today? Because I had to fit you in.
Oh,
wow. So my running is my passion. So I had to make sure that, you know, I'm still on my target and my track.
Absolutely wonderful.
Amazing. My goodness. So I was just wondering, what special rules or protocols do you does one have to follow to enter a marathon?
Okay, so first you have to find a race. And so, you know, races will determine whether it is a marathon or half marathon or 5K or so forth. And there are websites that you can go to that list various races, or you can go to the race itself if you're familiar with it. And then you click register, and you put in your information, your age, and your personal information, and then you you pay the money and you register. But certain races have a time frame in which you have to complete it. So you have to make sure that you're able to complete that race in that particular time frame. And so otherwise, you know, they don't know you, you don't know them, the directors, of course, and you just join the race and you run.
Well, I know this is what everybody's been asking, if you've been watching the show at all, is where are you in your target goal? How many races have you run total, and in terms of how many states which you've completed so far?
Okay, so total races to date, I think I ran close to 50 races overall, and that includes marathon, half marathon, 5Ks, 10Ks, 8Ks, so forth. But as you know, my journey is to run 50 half marathons in 50 states. So as of today, I've ran 17 of those states.
Yay!
Yeah. So a total of 21 half marathons, and a lot of those half marathons, a couple of them, I'm sorry, have been duplicate, like two in Virginia, three in Virginia. Mm-hmm. So that's why I've done more, because they were close to home. But now I've kind of stayed away from duplicating a state and just focus on the states that I have not completed yet.
And how many more years you have to go?
So, you know, I don't mind telling my age.
Okay.
I'm 42 years old. I'll be 43 this year.
All right.
And I've given myself to the age of 50. So I think I'm well on my journey because, I mean, this year alone, I have quite a few scheduled before the end of the year.
Excellent.
Yeah.
I would say so.
Yeah.
And I know that you're wearing these medallions or medals, whatever you may call them, but you have more of those, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I have a lot more, but you know, to me, you know, I know you guys see these and think that they're, you know, they're like really interesting, but I have friends that have so much more, and when I see them, I'm like, oh, and that just motivates me. And some people don't run for the medals. I mean, not saying I run for the medal, because my passion is to complete my journey, but I do like it at the end of the race. It is, for me, it's a reward to say that I've completed it. So I do like it. It makes me feel good.
Oh, so have you found that your running has inspired other people, not only to run, but maybe to accomplish other things in life, you know, after having seen you run?
Oh my gosh, yes. I mean, so often I get Facebook messages or emails from friends that see me and see my pictures, and tell me that, hey, I want to get started, or you motivated me, it's because of you mm-hmm. that I'm on this fitness journey, or I'm losing weight, mm-hmm. you know.
That's
good. Yeah, and so then, you know, some people call me their accountability partner. Okay. And so I tend to follow up with them and just say, hey, how are you doing? And I'm no expert, and so like when it comes to certain questions, I have friends that may have to ask certain questions to, mm-hmm. or I'll tell them to go to, you know, certain running stores and so forth, mm-hmm. you know. So.
Well, after 50 races, any wow. kind of race, wow. you yes. are an expert now. Absolutely. That's such a good question, Stephanie, in terms of inspiration, because you remind me of Miss Ernestine Shepherd, who was the oldest bodybuilder that we have, beautiful black woman, and she's 78 years old. As a matter of fact, you know, so that's huge. And you said you met her.
I did. I actually, my first encounter with Miss Ernestine was at the Baltimore Women's Classic. It was a 5K race, and she was there, and it was my first time seeing her. And my goodness, when I saw her, I was just so amazed at this woman. And I actually saw her out there running as well.
Yeah.
And I was in awe to know that this woman is out here doing the same thing we're doing, who is the age close to my grandmother's age, and I'm like, if she can do it, then everyone else should be able to at least get off the couch.
Right.
And then I also had the opportunity to hear her speak at our Black Girls Run conference that we had in Atlanta, Georgia. And so, mm-hmm. I mean, just an amazing woman and an inspiration for all of us.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. Mm-hmm. Steph. Oh, well, golly, I'm trying. So what other... I know we talked about your preparation. What kind of special foods, any type of diet, particular diet or regimen do you have to follow?
Especially
to
like the one. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I don't actually have a special diet, but I'm in a habit of doing certain things, especially like race day
okay.
and so forth. Well, pretty much every morning I eat like either a half a cup of oatmeal. That's like... it's like in my cabinet at work. So I do that. I eat a half cup of oatmeal. If I have time, I'll eat one boiled egg.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I take out the yolk. I mean, but it's, and sometimes I eat it. So, and I try to drink a lot of water.
Okay.
I do eat the oatmeal. But I do try to drink a lot of water. I did initially, when I was first losing the weight, cut out a lot of my carbs mm-hmm. and the breads, because of course, the lighter you are, the better, you know, it helps you. You know, when you're in your running journey, of
sure,
course.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so it does help. So, but nothing really special. I haven't, like I said, I initially cut out a lot of the fried foods
mm-hmm.
Because of my digestive system, as well as the way it makes your body feel, because you got to get out there and run.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Now, of course, Boston, the Boston Marathon has been like in the news, unfortunately, for not so good reasons recently, but what's your goal about getting there? And tell us about that, because what she told us about the Boston Marathon was fascinating.
Well, you know, Boston, for those that don't know about Boston, Boston is a runner's dream. And so if you're able to run the Boston Marathon, you know, normally, you know, runners who are out here running, whether they're doing it for leisure or just out here, period, it's something that people want to do, you know. And it's not one that you can just sign up. As we were talking about earlier,
right.
you know, you get online and you register. You have to qualify. And so they actually have guidelines for the Boston Marathon. It means BQ. You have to Boston qualify. One of my good friends, Jatola, just ran it for the first time. And so she qualified. So it depends based on your age. And so you have to run based on your age. So you have to do a certain time within, you know.
Wow.
Yeah.
And what would be the time?
I think mine is at the age of 42. I think it's like 3 hours and 40 minutes
mm-hmm.
or something like that. 340, 345. And that's huge, you know.
Wow.
I mean, that means that I have to do a lot of speed work. And I'm not saying that it cannot be done. It's just hard work and dedication. And so I've seen, just like, you know, the friend of mine who just ran it, I mean, she said she never thought that she would even make it there. And so the fact that she did it, you know, just it's just encouraging to know that you have others that are doing the same thing.
Absolutely. Okay, two questions I have for you. And one is, are they expensive? Are marathons expensive to join?
You know, marathons can be pricey. I mean, they can run up, they can be as low as, you know, $50, $60 sometimes. So if you get it like in advance, sometimes you get $10 off or a few bucks off based on discounts. And if you're in certain groups,
mm-hmm.
And then they can go up to a couple of $100. Okay. $200 or something like that. And I know people say it's a lot of money, but if it's your passion, it's like whatever you buy, whatever you want to purchase.
Sometimes it's a benefit, it goes to a cause, and sometimes it's for the city or the state, and what and all the preparation, administrative things that you have to do, logistical things.
Absolutely.
No, that's okay, because actually what you just said was one of the other question I was going to ask. It's like, well, what does all the money go towards when they're raising one if it's not for a benefit or a cause? And
So when you're running, I mean, think about it. You know, when you're running down the streets of here, Washington D.C., you have to close the streets down. You have police officers that are doing work. You have, and of course, you have the volunteers. You know, you have water stations, you have aid stations, and so they have to pay for all that stuff.
That makes
sense. So,
well, Felicia, very briefly, you have people out there that are sitting on the couch in their little fuzzy slippers, drinking whatever, eating all the pasta like I would want to do, or what, chocolate and all that kind of stuff. What would look at the camera and you tell people, just give them a little word or how to inspire them to maybe do whatever they'd like to do. If they wanted to run or something like that, what would you tell someone?
Well, your first thing you want to do is get off the couch. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to move. You know, whatever goal or whatever it is that you have or whatever you want to do, you have to move forward with that. You know, if it's a journey or if it's something that, you know, you have plans to do, you're not going to meet that goal by sitting still. And so once you get up and decide, this is what I want to do and be passionate about it, and it will definitely happen.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yes.
Felicia, thank you so much.
Yes.
You inspired me. And I hope this inspires you to not just run, if that is what you like to do, but whatever you want to do.
Yes.
If it's cooking, if it's just whatever. Whatever your passion is, whatever you really like to do, whatever you want to leave this earth and say you have done it, your bucket list, so to speak, get off the couch and do that thing.
Yes.
So, Felicia, if they want more information, how can they reach you? What email address?
Actually, you can use my email address. It's FA_AL@comcast.net. Again, it's FA_AL@comcast.net.
Okay, thank you so much for
listening. Thank you for having me.
We're going to have you at the end when you finish it all up.
Absolutely.
So if you have more information about this, if you don't get to Felicia, if you want to get to us, you can email us at lifematters@gmail.com. So keep those running shoes on, and we'll see you at the finish line. I'm going to have some pasta. See ya!
Thank you.
That was good.